Well, here I am again, and have another song. This one is called The Change. I write songs for a variety of different reasons. Sometimes spirit speaks to me. Sometimes there's something I want to say. Sometimes there's an animal that I find, like Mr. Squirrel, who actually I train to come up and take seeds and nuts out of my hands. But in this particular case, the change was inspired by the brave young high school students in Marjory Stoneham Douglas High School who survived the horrible attack. And not only did they have the slings and arrows of the bullets going at, you know, attacking them, then we have I don't know any other way to put it, but the mindless talking heads like Alex Jones and Laura Ingraham and Ben Garrison and Bruce Thornton coming after them and attacking them because they're against the proliferation of attack rifles and semi-automatic rifles available to the public. We're still seeing people being gunned down in high schools and playgrounds and in our communities. So the way I developed the change in terms of structurally, I wanted something that can sort of be a chant, but can also be sung by the people in the demonstration or whatever. So, of course, I include March for Our Lives and I include Never Again. But I also include Me Too and Hear Me Too, you know, and the fact that this generation has unique challenges and it also has unique opportunities. But what can create that is by having strong communities. Now, the structure of the song is, as I said, it's sort of like a chant. I have specifically designed the song so that if you have a challenge that you're dealing with, you can adapt this and plug in your own versing ends to the song, so that whether it's, I have that all lives matter, but if it's a black rally, there's no reason why it can't be Black Lives Matter. If it's Hispanic, it could be Hispanic Lives Matter. This is designed so that you can tailor the song to your own needs and your own desire. So essentially, there is a verse, and then chorus, and then verse, and then I have a bridge. In truth, if it was just a chant type thing, you would not have bridges and you would not have choruses. You might have the choruses, but you can even have a song without any of them. The idea is to be adapting the song to your own specific needs. And I hope you enjoy the song. So please listen to it. I hope this gives some insight to why I wrote the song and what the song is about. And when I think of some of these students, by the way, if anyone knows Emma Gonzalez or David Hoag or Sarah Caldwick, please forward this so that they can appreciate the songs. That it's their heroism and strength is what inspired the song, and I do hope that in some way, shape, or form someday they get to hear it. Enjoy.